So what I'm going to be doing is this birdhouse, not necessarily the bird, just the birdhouse. The rest of this page is going to be part of my Colorsoft, Derwent Colorsoft versus Prisma Premier comparison. I thought that would be a fun thing to do since they seem to be so similar, yet but there are some key differences. So the rest of this will be part of that, but I just wanted to do, a little special just on the birdhouse. So, yeah, let's get to it.
Thank you.
front part of the birdhouse. This is basically, by and large, how I would do the rest of the birdhouse. I may go in and do the shadow area and the roof, but these are the basic colors that I used to go over. I used a deep red, just a little bit though. Blackberry, loganberry, cream, didn't use that, yellow ochre, let's see, brown black, very good for the shading areas, petrol gray, which was mostly just up in here and down a little bit, black. Use the gray. Let's see. Pimento. Ginger. Just a little bit though. Mid terracotta, I think. Dark terracotta. I used a lot of that. Ochre. Lichen green, Lincoln green, dark brown, brown earth, pale brown. Used a lot of cream. Just said, I used a lot of, and brown, but I used a lot of cream. The cream color is basically my base for my highlights. So that's where this color comes from, is that's the base for the highlights. And then I just kind of, you know, colored around it. So, having said that, I'm going to finish the rest of this and we'll have a final chat. like right here. Sorry. I did this part right here, and I finished up this and this. I guess because it was kind of just repeated the same thing. So, the colors that I used for the birdhouse were blackberry, 280. Just a little of the deep red, and that was mostly right up in here to sort of be a reflection of the flowers, because my light source is coming this way, which is why this is shadowed this the way it is. I did also use a little a can pastel for the shadow here, because I had blended it out and it was kind of wax bloomy, kind of, and it didn't look good. So I just went over. If that ever happens to you, just if you have like a little pan pastel type stuff, just go gently go over it, and it'll fill all that in. And as you can see, it covered it up quite nicely, and it smoothed it out. So, that's a little tip. But I used the deep red mostly up in here to kind of reflect that. Petrol gray 680, ochre 590, pale brown 530. This is a great blender color. Lichen green 500, loganberry 160, cranberry 150. And that was again mostly kind of in here, but the loganberry was actually used all throughout, and especially in darker areas, it gave it kind of a richness, and again, the influence of the cherry blossoms. Brown earth 630, pimento 540, white sand 580, great blender color, and a great highlighter color also. That's light sandy cream. Are the two main colors that I used for the highlighted areas, white, gray, and the cream, 10, and the white, gray was 710, black, 650, brown, black, I used a lot of that, 640, blue terracotta, 620, dark brown, 520, quite a bit of that, and that in the background, just brown 510, dark terracotta 610, ginger 550, and I use this sparingly. Don't want too much of that because then it kind of overtakes the picture. Lincoln green 480, dove gray 670, and yellow ochre 50. So those are basically the colors that I've used, and I have those right here. As you can see, a whole nice two handfuls of them. Yes, I used all these colors in that one picture. Isn't that amazing? just this part. All these pencils. Right. But see, that's where you get the depth. You know, I used a lot of mid-tones, a lot of reflective tones to indicate the flowers. I used a little bit of blue up here. Ice blue. I don't have it out, but it's just right in here to reflect the birds. And then I have a lot of my dark tones to fill out the depth, and then the lighter tones for the contrast. So that's basically how I did this bird. I think it came out great. I loved it. So anyway, the rest of this picture, I'm gonna pull this out here. The rest of this picture, I'm trying to zoom out just a little bit. Sorry about that. Look be featured in a video that I'm going to do, where I'm going to be contrasting Derwent Colorsofts with Prism Clear. So be on the lookout for that. I'm getting my facts and everything in order so that I don't have like a bubbling pool. And so that I can impart as much knowledge and what I've learned as possible. So yeah, be on the lookout for that, guys, and have a blessed one.